Please subscribe.
New for 2018. A new cell trim joins the lineup offering leather and sync 3. The 2018 Escape cell is positioned above the S and SE trims but below the titanium trim. The 2.0-liter turbocharged I4 is now only available in the top titanium trim. Trim levels. The compact 2018 Ford Escape crossover is positioned above the new subcompact EcoSport but below the midsize Edge, 3-row Flex, 3-row Explorer, and 3-row Expedition SUVs. 2018 Escape S, the Bass S trim comes equipped with the 2.5-liter I4 engine, 17-inch steel wheels, 6-way manual front seats, sync infotainment system with a 4.2-inch screen, ice blue instrument panel lighting, automatic headlights, LED tail lights, and a rear view camera. 2018 Escape SE, the SE trim adds the 1.5-liter turbocharged I4 engine, 17-inch alloy wheels, 10-way power driver's seat, dual-zone climate control, sync with Sirius XM satellite radio, one touch up, down on all windows, fog lights, dual chrome exhaust tips, and black roof rails. 2018 Escape cell, the new cell trim builds off the SE trims, adding leather trim front seats, a power lift gate, heated side view mirrors, heated front seats, signature LED lighting, sync 3 with the Wi-Fi hotspot and Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, an 8.0-inch center touchscreen, a leather-wrapped steering wheel and gear shift knob, and rear parking sensors. 2018 Escape Titanium, the top trims comes equipped with the 2.0-liter turbocharged I4 engine, adds 18-inch wheels, a 10-way power passenger seat, driver's seat memory, a 10-speaker Sony audio system, a heated steering wheel, an auto-dimming rearview mirror, a 110-volt power outlet, interior ambient lighting, quick entry with the push-start ignition, remote engine start, a self-parking system, silver roof racks, and a foot-activated liftgate. The 2018 Ford Escape is available with the Ford Smart and Safe package of driver-assist safety features, all-wheel drive, a panoramic moonroof, and 19-inch alloy wheels, and a navigation system. Performance and fuel economy. The Escape's base engine is a 2.5-liter I4 with 168 horsepower and 170 pounds-foot of torque. Only available on the Escape S, the Ford delivers an EPA-rated 21/29 of a mile per gallon city highway with front-wheel drive. All-wheel drive is not available on the Bass engine. The optional engine is a 1.5-liter turbocharged I4 that produces 170 horsepower and 177 pounds-foot and is rated at 23/30 of a mile per gallon with FWD and 22/28 of a mile per gallon with AWD. The top 2.0-liter turbocharged I4 engine makes 245 horsepower and 275 pounds-foot and delivers 21/28 with FWD and 20/27 with AWD. All engines are mated to a 6-speed automatic. In our testing, the 2017 Ford Escape with the 1.5-liter turbo 4 and FWD hit 60 miles per hour in 9.2 seconds and stopped from 60 miles per hour in 126 feet. Safety. The 2018 Ford Escape received the highest 5-star overall safety rating from the NHTSA. In its testing, the Escape received the second highest rating of acceptable for the driver's side small overlap front crash test and the highest rating of good in the other 4 conducted crash tests. The lowest rating of basic was issued for the front crash prevention test for properly warning the driver of a possible collision thanks to the optional forward collision warning feature, but the Escape does not offer emergency automatic braking. The available Ford Safe and Smart package consists of rain-sensing windshield wipers, adaptive cruise control, forward collision warning with brake support, automatic high beams, blind spot monitoring with rear cross-traffic alert, lane keep assist, and a windshield wiper de-icer. Utility, cargo space and interior room. The Escape offers a healthy amount of cargo room with 34.0 cubic feet behind the rear seats and 68.0 with the rear seats folded down. The new Chevrolet Equinox offers 29.9 cubic feet and 63.5, respectively. Front passengers receive 43.1 inches of legroom and the rear seats offer 37.3 inches. Technology. Standard tech for the Escape includes the sync infotainment system displayed on a 4.2-inch center screen with voice recognition and a rear-view camera. The upgraded Sync 3 system comes displayed on an 8.0-inch center screen and comes with the Wi-Fi hotspot, SiriusXM satellite radio, and Apple CarPlay and Android Auto smartphone compatibility. A 6-speaker audio system is standard and a 10-speaker Sony system is optional. Other tech features include remote engine start, a self-parking system, a foot-activated power liftgate, and a 110-volt power outlet. The Ford Pass app allows the owner to do several things such as finding parking, looking up vehicle information and scheduling service, locating fuel stations and comparing prices, locking, unlocking and starting your Escape remotely. What we think. In a first test review of the 2017 Ford Escape 2.0 EcoBoost, we felt that outloaded titanium tester with AWD was pricey at $39,010, comparable to a mid-level Explorer. However, during SUV of the Year testing, judges praised the crossover's handling dynamics and neutral chassis, saying it drove very much like a hot hatch. You can tell that Ford of Europe had their hand in there somewhere. Acceleration was quick and real MPG testing numbers surpassed the EPA's. We enjoyed the roomy interior and technology but felt the styling was showing its age. All the goodness to be found in the 2017 Ford Escape could be had for several thousand dollars less than this loaded titanium example. Consider the mid-grade SE trim with the outstanding 2.0-liter EcoBoost engine. This version might have even won that mega comparison test, and will suit both a driving enthusiast and the economy enthusiast, we concluded. In a big test comparison of 9 compact crossovers, the Ford Escape SE with a 1.5-liter EcoBoost engine came in 6th place. The aged interior, tight backseat and slow acceleration took a toll on its ranking. In 6th place is the Ford Escape SE. The Ford has a lot going for it from a ride and handling perspective, but there's more to being a good family hauler than good dynamics. Its sluggish instrumented testing performance and tight cabin are really what sunk the Ford, we said.